Here we have one of the less common varieties of Ohia. This is Metrosideros polymorpha variety Macrophylla. So Macrophylla indicates that it has large leaves, and this is the distinguishing characteristic of this tree. It has these very large leaves. It's a medium to large tree of the forests of Maui and Hawai'i Island only, and it grows at these mid-elevation forests. So today we're in volcano at about 4,000 feet. This is a typical area where you would see Macrophylla. Another characteristic of Macrophylla is the bark separates in long, thin strips. This is a young tree, so we may not really be seeing much of this development. Now, Macrophylla is distinguished by these very large leaves. You see this leaf here is probably about 4 inches long, or about 10 centimeters. They are glabrous, so they're shiny both on the upper and the lower surfaces, much like glaberrima. Macrophylla also has large flowers. They are red. Now, an unusual thing about Macrophylla is the most recent genetic evidence doesn't separate it out as a botanical taxon. Now, it is in the book, when you look up the taxonomy in the Manual of the Flowering Plants of Hawaii, Macrophylla is, based on its morphology, based on what it looks like, is a separate subspecies. But DNA analysis indicates that it may not be. So just as you could do DNA and see your mother and father and you and your brother are more closely related than your cousins, you can do the same sort of analysis with trees. So when you throw all the Big Island Ohia together, incana clusters over here, and glaberrima over here, and newellii is different, and polymorpha is different, but this one was all over the board, and so it didn't seem to be clustering out. So that may be evidence from the genetics that it's not actually a separate botanical taxon, but right now we're treating it as one. And the take-home message is that the molecular genetics are definitely rewriting Ohia taxonomy. One of the most common varieties of Ohia is Metrosideros polymorpha variety incana. Incana means gray, and the defining characteristic of incana is that the leaves tend to be fuzzy or gray on the undersides, as you see here. In fact, even the buds are kind of fuzzy when you look at the flower buds. Incana can be yellow or red flowered, as we see here. It's one of the most common trees and found on all the islands except on Kauai for some reason. You can tell the difference between incana and polymorpha partly because the leaf edges are flat in incana, whereas polymorpha, the leaf edges are curled under, or revolute. Typically also incana grows at the lower elevations and on the younger substrates, as we see here in South Hilo. This is a fairly younger lava flow. We're only at about 700 feet elevation, so this is a typical place you'll find incana. Polymorpha is also fuzzy buds, fuzzy leaf undersides, but the leaf edges curl under, and mostly you see polymorph up at the higher elevations, up at several thousand feet up. Variety incana may have either red or yellow flowers, and it can grow from small trees all the way up to quite large trees. Although incana most commonly has red flowers, you can also find yellow-flowered ones and even orange-flowered ones. The red-flowered ones are called lehua apapane, after the apapane bird, which has red feathers, and the yellow-flowered trees are named lehua mamo, after the mamo bird, which was a black bird with bright yellow feathers. With incana, even the buds tend to be fuzzy. This is a lot like polymorpha. Metrosideros polymorpha variety incana can be just small trees when it grows on the lava fields, but in older forests with deep soils, like here on the Hamakua coast, they can grow into real giants. This tree is about 5 feet in diameter and about 80 feet tall. Here we see one of the most common Ohia varieties in Hawaii. This is Metrosideros polymorpha variety glaberrima. Now, glaberrima can be small trees all the way to huge forest giants. We usually see it on mid-elevations here on Hawai'i Island, and we usually see it on the older substrates of the soils, not so much on the young soils. That's where we see incana. The main diagnostic of glaberrima is that the leaves tend to be smooth and shiny both on the top and the undersides. Whereas incana would be fuzzy on the underside here, this tree is glaberrima, so it's shiny on both. The leaves tend to be kind of egg-shaped as opposed to like a spear point shape like newellii would be. The new shoots are red, but otherwise the leaves are green, and the leaves are flat. They're not rolled under the edges. One thing you'll notice about glaberrima is that the new leaves and the new shoots tend to be bright red when they first emerge. Here we see an infection of the Austrobuccinia rust, or the Ohia rust, on a glaberrima leaf. It does seem that the rust is more severe on the smooth-leaved taxa of Ohia, such as glaberrima or
tremuloides or Hawai'i, than in the pubescent or the fuzzy varieties. So you often see this rust attacking glaberrima, and you seldom see it attacking incana or polymorpha, which are the fuzzy leaf varieties. The rust can kill small seedlings, and sometimes it seems to infect entire trees in the forest.
Glabrima can have red or yellow flowers, so flower color actually isn't a very good criterion for determining what taxon you're looking at, because, for example, incana can also have red or yellow flowers. Glabrima can also grow to enormous trees, especially here on the Hamakua coast of the Big Island, where we have deep soil and plenty of rainfall. This tree is about 100 feet tall. Here we have a special variety of Ohia. This is newellii. Newellii is special because it only lives on the Hilo Hamakua coast of Hawaii Island. You can tell it's different by the leaves are sort of spear tip shaped or lance shaped. They are glabrous on the underside, so they're smooth on the underside. And they have the leaf stems or petioles are usually red. The other thing you can tell about newellii is the inflorescences, they're kind of spread out a little bit more than normally. Nuellai, you can tell the difference because the leaves are kind of spear tip shaped or lanceolate, as opposed to other varieties which tend to be more round. The leaves themselves are on these small stems, which are usually bright red in color, and they're on about a quarter inch to a half inch stems, whereas some of the leaves are right up against the stem here. Also, the inflorescence. Now, this one has gone past. The flowers have gone, and it's all the little fruit, all the little capsules are developing now. But they tend to be more open and spaced out. The other ones tend to be more compact. Nuellii is an unusual variety because it only lives on the Hilo Hamakua coast and only lives right on the banks of streams. In fact, the Nuellii actually has adaptations that allow it to survive the storm surge. So you'll only see it basically within the splash zone of streams.
Nuellii has red flowers and almost purple-colored new shoots, or liko.
For this variety of Ohia, we've come up here to the slopes of Mauna Loa, high up. We're at about 6,700 feet elevation here on the lava lands. And we have a fairly common subspecies here, and a pretty rare one. The common variety we're seeing here is Metrosideros polymorpha, variety polymorpha. So the specific name is the same as the variety name. So it's polymorpha, variety polymorpha. This is the common variety that we see at high elevations on lava lands. And it really looks different. The main way it looks different is how fuzzy the leaves are. So even the tops of the leaves are fuzzy. The buds are fuzzy. The little leco coming out are fuzzy, the tops of the leaves are fuzzy, even the stem here is a little bit fuzzy. Then the leaves are almost exactly right up against the stem. There's not much of a leaf stem at all. So if you look at the new leaves, they're almost clasping the stem in some ways. Then the last diagnostic, the way you tell the difference between this and another variety, the other variety in Cana, that's also fuzzy on the underneath, is this is fuzzy on the underneath, but the leaves have a little lip on the edge. You can feel it with your fingernail, that there's a little lip on the edge of these leaves. They're curled under. It's called rebulate in the botanical taxonomy. So that, and of course, where it grows is also diagnostic, because this is growing high up on the mountain, whereas incana usually grows lower down. Here's a pretty little leco of polymorpha, and you can see how fuzzy it is, and how the leaves are just clasped right along the stem there. Polymorpha typically has dark red flowers like this one does. You will most often find polymorpha in these high elevation sites, like this one along the slopes of Mauna Loa. So now that you've learned some varieties of Ohia, we have a test for you all here on this tree. Once again, we're back up on the slopes of Mauna Loa. We're at about 6,700 feet elevation. Most of the trees like that one over there are variety polymorpha. But what about this one? So this variety has red flowers, which is one clue. But I really want to draw your attention to the leaves, which is another clue. So these leaves are flat and shiny on the top. They're flat with no rolled edges. Some of the bottoms are pubescent or fuzzy. Some of them are smooth. But the key thing is that the fuzz on the bottom, you can rub off with your fingers, comes off there. So this variety is a hybrid. It's probably a hybrid of incana or polymorpha and glaberrima. So it shows characteristics of both the large, glossy, light-colored leaves and of the glaberrima, and the fuzz on the underside of the incana, but the fuzz you can rub off. So thanks for coming along with us and learning about varieties of Ohia. A takeaway message from all this is that Ohia is very diverse, and we don't yet understand all the diversity, all the different varieties that are out there. And there are also hybrids going on. So they aren't true species, they can cross-pollinate, and they come up with some very curious trees like this one, which is a hybrid of two varieties. Thanks for coming along, and go out there and explore. Aloha.